Ladies and gentlemen, come gather around, come gather around, come gather around. Today, we're going to make a sway bar for this wonderful Korean suppository, because I like my cars like I like my bowels, fast and loose. Let's go! We're going to use this Hossfeld bender and this piece of 7/8 round steel to make a sway bar for my Hyundai Accent. Check out the playlist over here. Yes, mild steel. Yes, it'll work. 5 feet. I want to find the middle, because this is bigger than I need. I need 2.5 feet, which is 2'6". Right there is the middle. It needs to be 36 inches overall. So that would be 1.5 feet, which would be 1'6". From there, and one foot six from there. You can always cut the ends shorter. So I got my little marks on there. So the Hossfeld is one of the 7 wonders of the universe. If it can be bent, it can be bent by a Hossfeld. And man, there's, like, I can't remember all the settings, but it does come with a book, a manual, and you can find that online, which shows you how to set it up. All the dies are painted red so that people don't accidentally cut up a useful die and make it into some cool project. One thing you need to be aware of is how much of the bend is lost, or how much of the width is lost when you're doing your bend. And in this case, it's 2¾, so you need to place it correctly in the Hossfeld to make that happen for you. And then, like, bend, and it took all my strength. The sway bar itself is 36 inches wide with 10-inch arms. The brackets to mount it are 5-inch by 3-inch. I think I cut them out of 3/16 plate. And there are holes drilled every 1.132 inches. And that gives you a little bit of adjustability. My first sway bar had way too much adjustability. It's not that fine a detail. Oh, I probably show you on the dial caliper where the hole placement is here. You might need to pause it and take a look at it, because I think it's 1.132. At any rate, I did basically 3 different positions on these brackets because I didn't find a huge difference in the other one. If you do math with the sway bars, a 5/8 bar gives you about 84 pounds per inch of roll resistance. The 3/4, which is only like 1/8 of an inch bigger, goes up to 174 pounds per inch mathematically. And the 7/8 bar, which we're making here, adds 323 pounds of roll resistance. I believe it is to the 3rd power. So the cube, you're cubing the increase in diameter, and that's a massive increase in roll resistance with sway bars. So a little goes a long way. I did weld the brackets together, which makes drilling all the holes in the same place and making them look uniform and symmetrical nice. I was wearing gloves. I like to wear gloves. Never wear gloves. I will still wear gloves. Don't wear gloves. I like gloves. I did roll up the sleeves, because you can't argue with that. Once these all looked really good and saucy. All
right, so we've got to remove the skinny bar.
We take the bar off, the old one. And it was okay. This 3/4 inch bar made the car handle nice. It was acceptable. It turned it from a spoon in a bowl of oatmeal into a dish rag with maybe a bit too much soap. It was better. It was acceptable. But we can always make it better. So with the brackets in and the bar sitting into place, we MIG weld it. You could take it if you want. I didn't, because I don't care. And when you weld this, you want to weld it fairly thoroughly so that there's no little cavities or pockets. Because once you paint this, moisture is going to find your little cavities and pockets. Now, if this was really a sway bar material, like a higher carbon spring steel kind of thing, you'd want to go get this heat treated and all the other fancy stuff that goes with it. Don't care. It'll work. This is not my first sway bar. It does work. Whatever steel you use for making a sway bar, they all have the same modulus of elasticity, whether it's hardened or heat treated or whatever. So what matters is that you don't take this bar out of its range of elasticity. If you bend it too far and it doesn't come back to its original shape, it's failed, and you either need a bigger bar or That's probably the case for a spring steel bar. In this case, it's going to work. We sprayed it with two coats of a 2K epoxy primer, and when that set up nice and saucy-like, I sprayed it with red, which I had. This is a 2K polyurethane enamel. Spray it all nice and pretty-like, and we'll see how it lasts in a winter underneath a car. This should be a durable paint. I'm always open for disappointment. So we'll get the old bar off. I didn't position this well on the hoist, so I need to use a universal. And I don't have any impact universals at work, so I just held on to the little chromie and wished it wouldn't fly across the room and hit me in the face. Not necessarily in that order. At any rate, pops out pretty good. Just a little bit of wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Yeah. Animal print pants out of control, yo.
And before we put the new one on, let's take a look at the two side by side, all painted like. So now you can totally see the difference in size. The first one was 3/4 inch, aftermarkets are 5/8, and this one is 7/8. So I'm up a significant amount thicker. All right, let's put it on. Well, that was easy. Now to see if it works.
And the illustrious, boring commute in the Hyundai Accent on my way to work. This is a pretty fun road. Years ago, I used to use parts of this road as kind of my gauge for whether the changes and modifications I made to a vehicle made any difference at all. And honestly, most of them don't really make a huge difference for power. Fancy exhaust, free-flowing mufflers, all that stuff don't really make a significant gain, but that's beyond the scope of this video today. Today, it's trying out the sway bar. Not a whole lot we can do, just taking a little route. This is the brand new last year Hank Grenda Middle School in Lake Country. I am one of the remaining teachers who actually worked with Hank Grenda before he passed away years ago. One round through the roundabout, that's always a fun way to tell how well your vehicle handles. This is also a professional development day, so there are no kids, so it's not actually a school zone or nothing. So that's kind of nice. Then another roundabout, which is always kind of fun. I really just have my good old camcorder sitting in the back, which is why it has a seizure every so often. Car handles fine. Feels good in the roundabout. I really like this sway bar. If you push it, it'll do weird things. It becomes really fun. But it's actually a really decent, really happy with this bar. So I would say 7/8 is the perfect bar size for the back of this Hyundai Accent. And then we're into my school parking lot. So cool. How does it work? Let's do a little conclusion, shall we?
And now that we're back home, right here is where I'm going to put the link to the video for all the naysayers who are like, oh my gosh, you can't make a sway bar out of cold rolled mild steel, you're nuts! Well, maybe I can. It's here, it runs, it drives, and handles good, I'm liking it. I had a smaller sway bar on it for like 6 months, now it's gone up to a fatter sway bar. You know, go big or go home, that's the way we roll here. Nevertheless, here it is. It's going. Stay tuned for the next exciting whatever it is I'm going to do with whatever this is. Thanks for watching. Take care.